I think it is at three different levels. First, I think we've fundamentally seen a change in the way that the constitutional process works. We're now seeing a Senate that is basically being operated like the House of Representatives, which is unfortunate in my opinion, where issues come to the floor, and rather than having open and fairly lengthy debate with lots of amendments, it's structured in a very dogmatic way in the sense that basically amendments aren't allowed, or if they are allowed, they're very limited. Second, and that changes the purpose of the constitutional structure. The Senate was supposed to be the place, as Washington said, from which the hot coffee is poured from the cup into the saucer. And the saucer's now sort of been thrown out the window. The second big thing that I think is happening here is that the government is growing very dramatically. And the cost of the government is growing dramatically. We're going to go from a government that historically has been about 20% of GDP to a government that's now going to exceed probably 25, 27% of GDP. Those are big numbers. And it's going to be very hard to pay for that government. And I think in the end, it's probably going to weaken our country to have a government that large, because we will either have to finance that government through massive increases in taxes, which produces productivity, or potentially even inflation, which obviously is the cruelest tax of all. Thirdly, obviously, the president has a big win. That's pretty historical. He sort of put his whole presidency on the line here, and he has a big win. I happen to think it's a win that pushes our government, regrettably, too far left and moves us down the road towards a European type of government. But it certainly can't be denied that this is a big win.
Do you think that's the government he prefers, that kind of government? A European-style social democracy?
Yeah. Absolutely. I mean, not only is the health care bill passed, but you know they threw the baggage on this train of nationalizing the entire student loan industry. I mean, the entire student loan industry, more or less under the radar, has been nationalized so that 19 million students who get their loans today from private banks are going to get them from the federal government as a result of that legislation being put on this bill. And then, of course, you have the movement in the area of financial reform. You have the movement in the area of the automobiles. So there's no question this is as you said, a European approach, which basically believes in more of a social democracy type of approach, where the entrepreneurship that has been the core of the American value system, in my opinion, which has caused the creativity and the energy for our nation, is really dampened down by a government that's just awfully big and awfully intrusive.
So the defining battle that this president will face for the remainder of his first term and 4 years of a second term, if he gets it, will be what?
Well, I think it's just how far to the left do we go.
So, therefore, you think what will happen in 2010 and 2012?
I suspect the American people will want a divided government again. I think they're going to want the checks and balances that come from having the White House in one hand and at least one house of the Congress in the other party's hands. I don't think they like to see this lurching that is occurring, in this case, to the left, and this massive increase in government. Because they intuitively understand. You know, American people have tremendous common sense. It's an intuitive common sense. They understand intuitively that if this government gets as large as it's going to get under this administration's proposals, their kids aren't going to be able to afford it. They're going to have a different quality of life. Standard of living will go down.
Join us online at charlierose.com.